念你好，非常荣幸能够对您进行采访，再次对您当选基督城市长表示祝贺。
Thank you。
念您在竞选期间提出了很多的施政构想，对未来工作也表达出了强烈的信心。现在担任市长已经一个多月了，您觉得目前总体的情况与您当时的预期相符吗？
Yeah, well, I've been in the job now for 7 weeks since the election, and actually tomorrow will be the 5 weeks of being officially sworn in. No, it's very much what I thought it would be, except that it's a lot bigger. You know, instead of just representing one part of Christchurch, I get calls from all around Christchurch. I've been lots of places and met lots of people. It's been a bit of a whirlwind, actually.
现阶段我们市政府对基督城震后重建的重点是什么呢？
Well, our new council has come in quite fresh and, you know, sort of ready for action, as it were. Only 4 of the old council have been re-elected, so 10 of us are brand new. Yeah, so it's been, well, we've been ready to hit the ground running, and I think our top priority has been to re-establish relationships. Relationships are really important to, you would know from a business perspective, relationships are fundamental to doing good business. So we've started off by having meetings with the Minister of Earthquake Recovery, with the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Authority, with the Regional Council, with the other councils in the area, and also with various community groups. And we've started to just build those relationships. One of the really important ones is with Ngāi Tahu, which is the iwi, the large, it's the Māori tribe that covers virtually the whole of the South Island. And for us, that's a very important relationship.
您觉得华人社区在未来的重建过程中将发挥什么样的作用？
Well, I think that making sure that all of our communities are able to engage with the recovery is again also a very much a priority. So it's not just about bringing the business community or just the focus on the rebuild. It's actually what do people who live in the city think that they want from their city in the future. And it can be very easy to leave people out of that discussion. So I've taken the role myself as mayor to be on the Multicultural Council. And the reason that I've put myself out there is to send a signal to all of the migrant communities that have chosen Christchurch as their home, that their mayor, their council, thinks that their involvement is very, very important.
中国已经成为新西兰最大的贸易伙伴，而我们基督城是新西兰第二大城市。您觉得基督城在两国双边贸易关系上将扮演什么样的角色？
Well, I think from bilateral trade point of view, it's actually fundamentally important. So, and I guess you think of Christchurch looking out to the Canterbury Plains. I mean, you know, in terms of food and water issues, which are huge issues for China as well, we will be, I think, able to partner in a way that will benefit both countries. So in terms of research and science, going into those area of proteins the milk and all of those things, food security, big issue in China as well, and we have so much to learn from each other. And I often think, you know, we're a tiny country, what can we offer a big country like China? But actually we have some advanced knowledge around food security and around traceability, which are all very important issues. So I think that Canterbury and Christchurch's place servicing the Canterbury region means that the relationship with China is extremely important.
对于新西兰旅游业来说，中国市场无疑具有无限的潜力，而我们基督城也曾经是最受中国游客欢迎的旅游目的地之一。但是遗憾的是，地震之后我们失去了很大一部分的中国游客，所以在这一方面，我们市政府是不是有什么样的计划来重新吸引我们中国游客来到基督城旅游观光呢？
I think that people will want to come back and see us rebuilding, you know, and I mean it's going to be part of, you know, the a journey that we're going to be on. And I think it's going to be quite exciting for people that perhaps came here before the earthquake, who come here after the earthquake, and then in the future come back and see what's actually happened. So I think that that's an offering in its own right. A lot of people from China who came here as visitors didn't just come to Christchurch. They came to Christchurch, spent some time here, and then they moved on round other parts of the South Island. I think that will still happen. And I'm encouraging people to take the time to have a look at Christchurch the way it is now, because, you know, we are literally building the newest city in the world. Yes. And what a great opportunity to see the beginning of that and to be able to share that journey with us.
地震对基督城另一大影响就是我们国际留学生的流失。对此，我们的市政府都有哪些应对措施呢？
International students are already coming back. They're flooding back into the city, and it's great. So again, I think that anyone who is able to show an employer in the future that they got their degree in Christchurch, you know, given all of the things that we've been through, then this will show that this person, these young people that come through their qualifications here now and in the near future, they will be able to say that we have something extra to offer employers in the future. So I think that Christchurch has got a great opportunity. We've got two fantastic universities. We've got Canterbury University and Lincoln University, and these two universities provide enormous potential for young students. And then we've also got a fantastic polytechnic, which is a technical institute, CPIT. And again, their student numbers have improved as well, international student numbers. I think that we'll have other joint offerings in the future. So we will start thinking about partnering with other universities around the world to have joint offerings here in Christchurch. And I think that the ability to do that comes from really what we've been through and our connections with both the Canterbury Plains and our connection with Antarctica.
目前在世界上的很多国家都出现了汉语热，而新西兰呢也有越来越多的学校在开设我们的汉语课程。李彦，您怎么看待这一现象呢？
There are some who are adding it in. So it's, we don't have a mandatory curriculum as such. We have a curriculum, but it's very much based on the on what people get out of it. So there are some schools that are starting to teach Mandarin. And I mean, it's very important that children learn other languages. So, I mean, when I was at school, it was French and German. You know, when my mother was at school, it was Latin, you know, so I think that, and I remember my grandfather saying to me at that time, and this was many, many years ago, that that I shouldn't be learning French and German, I should be learning Japanese at that time, because there was a, you know, a trade and the tourism and everything was in that area. I think if he were alive today, he would say, you should be learning Mandarin.
但是仍然还是有一些批评家认为，在学校推广汉语其实是一种文化渗透，甚至是一种文化侵略。您怎么看待这一观点？
No, not at all. Look, I'll tell you a story. I remember hearing the head of the dairy board, who was the dairy board was before Fonterra. So, and the dairy board head, he was Sir Dryden Spring.He spoke at a conference and he said that when they were sending people to work in other countries, they had made a decision, and this is going back a number of years now, they'd made a decision that they would not send people into these other countries unless they had the language of the country. So if they were sending somebody into China, they would have Mandarin up north, they would have Cantonese down south. You know, and all of the other countries, they would make sure they could speak the language. And he said that it didn't matter that those countries had learnt English, because he said what was most important was the cultural relationship, and the only way to the culture was through the language. Excellent. And I've always remembered that. So no, it is not a cultural invasion, it is a cultural imperative that we learn other languages.
Fantastic.
We
林彦霖在工党告别演说会上曾引用一句中国的俗语，妇女撑起半边天。对这一俗语，我觉得您应该有很多的切身体会。您是怎么看待妇女从政的呢？
I think it's pretty fundamental that women are involved. I love that expression, women hold up half the sky. It's so true. And it just captures the essence of what many of us have been talking about for many, many years. And it frustrated me, which is why I said that in my valedictory speech. It frustrated me that every time we try to achieve that equality, that expression entails, every time we raise it, somebody has to shoot it down. So, I thought it was a great expression.
您觉得作为一名女性市长，您的性别给您带来的更多是优势还是劣势？
I'm not the first female mayor, and in fact, the first female mayor of Christchurch is now the deputy mayor of Christchurch.
Yeah, interesting. So you think it's...not a barrier.
No, it's not a barrier. No, certainly not these days. It may have been in the past, but it is not a barrier. In fact, I think it's a distinct advantage to have, you know, a strong woman leading the way.
最后，林彦霖希望通过我们的电视台向基督城的华人朋友说些什么吗？
Just that I want people to understand that we're going through. No, maybe if I put it a different way, I want to show that the council understands that people are going through a very difficult time, but that there is enormous hope in front of us, and that this council is very willing to engage with all cultures so that we all have a role to play. And I did an interview with the Minister for Earthquake Recovery and Sir Mark Solomon from Ngāi Tahu just on television recently. And Sir Mark was asked the question about whether the city would become more bicultural. And he said the city would become more multicultural. And I thought that he really, really touched a strong point for our diverse population.
非常感谢您接受我们的采访，希望您今后的工作一切顺利，也欢迎您来到我们电视台做客，谢谢。
Thank you very much.